environmental group will file a lawsuit against the Environmental Protection Agency, accusing the feds of not protecting kids from what's called pesticide drift. Linda Yee shows us what one family found happening in the field next to their house, a field that grows a well-known brand of strawberries.
In this Northern California farming community, strawberry fields are everywhere.
It does make me nervous.
Melissa and Sam Sleezer live just feet away from one owned by Driscoll's, the popular brand we all see in supermarkets. It's lying fallow now, but once a year, it gets fumigated before planting.
We see a machine with 12, 13 people in these white chemical suits, gas masks, full gear.
The fumigant contains chloropicrin, a former chemical warfare agent. There are conflicting studies over whether it causes cancer, but Melissa points to a UC scientific panel that warns chloropicrin could be a potent carcinogen.
We've all grown our children here. They talk about they're 76 times more likely to get cancer having been exposed to this stuff.
Driscoll's has always reassured them there is no risk.
They're bringing strawberries.
And say, oh, you're perfectly fine. We would never put you in danger.
The children's grandfather, Manuel Silvera, was skeptical. Oakland-based Pesticide Action Network helped him set up drift catchers to monitor chemical droplets in the air during fumigation. The results?
It was scary. It was scary for especially for the kids.
Pesticide Action Network found levels of chloropicrin almost two times higher than what scientists paid by the state say is acceptable for adults. For children, it was four times higher. But California considers much higher levels acceptable. So, despite the family's appeals, the state did not find Driscoll's in violation.
The state and the federal government has set these levels so high that they'll never be within. It's impossible for them not to be within their legal rights.
We follow, all the appropriate laws and best practices in the industry.
Kelly Bell is with Driscoll. She says the company has gone above and beyond the law, paying for the Silvera family to stay in a hotel during fumigation.
You do take precautions.
Mm-hmm.
Your workers wear their hazard suits.
Absolutely.
And you do put tarps on it.
Mm-hmm.
And you do pay them to leave if they feel concerned about it. So all that points to that there is something back there that concerns you about these fumigants.
What I think that points to is that we are completely committed to following the law.
It's all very disappointing for the family.
We have to try to come together and just come up with, a way away from these really super dangerous chemicals.
But the strawberry industry says those safer alternatives are years away. In Tehama County, Linda Yee, KPIX 5.
Now, the state decided to go with higher acceptable levels of chloropicrin to conform with U.S. EPA guidelines. In that lawsuit that will be filed against the EPA tomorrow, the Pesticide Action Network wants the feds to make the regulations stricter for children's sake.